everyone, this is James Hubert with Hubert Steam Cleaning, coming at you with the Steam Dream episode 5. Today we're going to be talking about the manifestation. So if you remember our last episode, it was called The Test. This episode is called The Manifestation. The last video we were talking about my van that I had upgraded to. It was a 1980 E150. And I'm here to tell you today that if you keep going, God will keep blessing you. If you keep believing, God will keep blessing you. So the manifestation is, I went from a E150 Ford 1980 to a brand new E150 Transit with 80 miles on it. I don't know, for some reason that just kind of hit me as, you know, it just hit me. You know what I'm saying? That I went from a 1980 van to a van with 80 miles on it. Let me tell you about that van, because this is truly a manifestation. My 1980 E150 had, I call it ghost. I would be driving to a job and all of a sudden it would just turn off. I spent every penny I could. They changed out the radiator, the starter, everything on that van to try to keep it, you know, to understand what it was, but it would just turn off. One day I was going out to do, I had about five jobs, and I was broke because I had spent all my money on trying to keep that van running. It was, if you ever had an older vehicle, you'll know that you have problems, and that one had a lot of problems. But that day I was going out, I had about four or five jobs, and it was about 7:30 in the morning. And I got a friend that called me and he said, "Hey man, I'm off today. If you need me, give me, just let me know." And I'm like, "You calling me for?" He never calls me at 7:30. We talk, but we don't talk like that. And so he calls me that morning and I was like, okay. And I hung up the phone. Well, about 30 minutes later, I was driving down the highway and all of a sudden, boom, my van turned off. And I was truly dejected because I had went through all the money I had. I had went through all these things trying to fix this problem. And I just wondered, is this really what I'm supposed to do? Because this, I was ready to quit. I was thinking about jobs that I can go get at that point because it just was not working out. And so just so happened, I broke down and I wasn't that far from his house, maybe about 5 miles. And I gave him a call and I said, "Hey man, I'm going to take you up on your offer. I need you. I'm broke down on the highway." And so he came right up, picked me up. And he was like, he saw my face. I was absolutely broken. I had went through it. I mean, tires busting, axles breaking, the steering wheel drive broke. By the grace of God, I didn't hit anything. Just on and on and on. I had put thousands of dollars in this van, and that was all my profit. Every profit I had, I put back into that van to keep it going, to try to get to another job. But at this point, I was done. Well, he said, "Let's go eat some breakfast, man." Because what happens is when the van turned off, it would, in about an hour, it would crank back up. I don't know. It wasn't a heating thing. I had the coil change. But we went to eat breakfast, and he was saying that, "Man, you need to think about getting a new van." Well, I knew that. And just so happened about a week earlier or whatnot, I tried to apply online, and my credit wasn't good enough. They declined me. No way. You know, my scores were pretty low at the time. And there was no way I was gonna, get a newer one. And I didn't have any money to buy a replacement for that one. But he was saying that, and you gotta know this guy, he's kind of braggadocious. And he said that, "I used to work at this dealership and they know me." And I was like, "Well, when did you work there?" And he said, "About 15 years ago." Yeah, okay. So anyway, I'm like, "No, I'm not going to a dealership because I understand that my credit's not that great and they're not giving me a car and I don't have the mental right now to deal with that," because you know that some of the games you go through, they're gonna take you back and forth. Well, we sat there, we were eating breakfast, and he asked me again. He said, "Man, let's go down to this dealership, man. They knew me down there, And I'm like, "I'm not going." And so he asked me again, the third time. And I was like, "Man, whatever." He said, "What do you got to lose? Your car's broke down, you're out of business." And I said, "All right, let's go." So I went to the dealership, and in my mind, I had the question. I was going to ask them if they had something, maybe $4,000 or $5,000. I was going to see if I could scramble the money together some kind of way with family or whatever. And so the guy, I walked in the door and I told the guy, "Listen, my credit's not that great. Before we do anything, I need you to just run it. we can't get it, I'm going, because I don't have all day to set there. I'm already ticked off, basically. I mean, my van, I'm out of business. And so he took my information. He said, well, okay, I took my information, and he ran it, and he was sitting there, and I was waiting. I told him, he said he'd make a transfer of older van for me. So he pulls up in this brand new 2017 Ford Transit. And I'm like, I told you that I don't have any money, because I didn't have any money down. I told you that my credit's not good. And if you know anything about business, when you're in business, they require for you to have everything, you know, all your taxes and all of that. And I had a little bit of it, but my stuff wasn't tight. So he pulls around in his van and he said, let's go for a test drive. And I said, I'm not going for a test drive because I'm ticked off. I don't want to do this game. You know, if you can get me anything, help me out. If not, I'm gone. So he said, well, you got to drive it if you want to know if you want it. And I'm like, and I told my friend, I said, go look on that sticker. And it was, the van was like $32,000. Get out of here. First of all, I ain't got you no money for you. It's $32,000. More than I ever, you know, thought about. But that was a van that I had seen people drive. And I was like, one day, you know, maybe God will bless me with that van. You know, I'll get to a point where I can buy that van. And he said, well, we got a test drive. And I said, I'm not going to test drive. He said, well, sir, you need a test drive. I said, hold, listen, I don't want to drive this van because I know I can't get it. He said, well, let's go for a test drive anyway. So I told him, and this is funny. I said, listen, if I go for a test drive and you don't get me in this van, I'm going to punch you in your face. And I didn't smile. I was dead serious. I was just mad. I was upset, and I didn't want to go through those games. He said, well, it's a little guy. And he said, well, okay, let's test drive it. And I'm looking at him like, do you understand the consequences of me going to test drive this van? And so anyway, we went for a test drive, and we got back. And his concern wasn't me getting the van as how much my payment was going to be. God, the manifestation was, I got approved. I got approved with no money down. I got approved with bad credit, and they didn't access what they call stips at a car lot. I used to work for a car lot. That's what they call stips. They want you, you know, your taxes and all this stuff. They didn't ask for anything but my insurance. Praise God. All I can do is say, praise God. That was God telling me that this van was for you, that this business is for you, that everything that he promised was for me. And so I literally 30 minutes later, I was driving off in that van. And another funny story, before I left, I said, listen, now if you're going to play the games that you guys play at these car dealerships, and you tell me, you're going to call me tomorrow and say you need to bring it back, or I need to bring you whatever, I'm like, I don't have any money, and when I take this van, I'm going to put a lot of holes in it. I was going to put my old machine in there. You're not going to want it back in about 2 hours, because I had canceled my jobs, which I could not afford to do. So he was like, okay. So I drove off in a brand new 2017 with 80 miles on it, E150. That was one of the turning points or the biggest manifestations of God, what God had told me. I got the machine, somebody gave it to me. I got the customers, which God gave to me, and I got the truck that I needed at the appointed time that God gave it to me. This section is called the manifestation. My dog is cheering for me. And so this is James with Huberstein Cleaning. Make sure you tune in for the next episode. It's going to be called The Dream. We're looking forward to it. Thanks. And it's for real.